Okay, well, I'm Katrine Hoffman, and I was enslaved by the spirit of fear at a very young age. It started when I was bombed, or my surroundings were bombed when I was in kindergarten, and I was in the middle of it. And the enemy, that's when he really got a hold of me. But he also, from then on, found every opportunity to increase his hold on me by deaths in the family, my mother getting really, really sick, and lots of things along the way of my growing up years. He would always find a place to increase his hold. And when I came to the Lord, God was very gracious. In spite of the spirit of fear, God took me and helped me to grow up in Him. He helped me to become strong in His Word. He baptized me in the Holy Spirit. And I was never really truly aware that I was bound by the spirit of fear. I wasn't a fearful person. But the last 3 years, the enemy really increased his hold. And it was very interesting. I felt like I was being trapped in a net. And I struggled to get out, and I couldn't get out. And the enemy kept pulling tighter and tighter on that net. And it became smaller and smaller, and I became more and more confined and trapped in fear, to the point where there were times when I couldn't eat, when I couldn't sleep, I could barely function. And what really puzzled me was, I know the power of the Word. And I know the Word of God, and I know that the Word of God is my weapon, and Jesus is the living Word, and I will be absolutely fearless praying for other people and full of faith. But when I use the Word of God for my own circumstances, I couldn't seem to get any victory. Yes, there was for a short time there would be relief, but I would spend whole nights speaking the Word of God, fighting with the Word of God, and I wouldn't get relief. And it became so bad that the presence of the spirit of fear was known 24 hours a day, like a clammy presence. I would go to sleep with it if I could. I would go wake up with it when I woke up again, and I could never get rid of it. I couldn't enjoy life. I couldn't enjoy anything. And in my prayer room, I would just, several times it happened that I would lay down on the prayer couch and I would say, God, I can't do this anymore. Take me home. When we had this prophet, and I forget his name right now here, who talked about facing giants. And he said, there's always going to be a giant in your life, and he seems so big. And then you get to the point where he becomes small and you are bigger than him, but then there will be another giant to fight. And he was so excited about that. That was exciting to him, and to me it was like a death sentence. I can't do this anymore. I just don't have the strength. I don't look forward to being used in the end times. I just don't have the strength. And finally it got so bad. And the way the enemy brought me into panic mode was always through physical symptoms. And telling me I had cancer, or I was going blind, or I was going deaf, or whatever. And finally it got so bad that one day I just picked up the phone. No, yeah, I picked up the phone and I called the church. I said, I need help. I can't do this anymore. And Pastor Gail was out of town, but Greg immediately responded to me and sent me an email. And I had been going to the soaking meetings on Tuesday night. And so he met me there and he prayed for me. And out of it really came, I said, maybe I should come to RTF and go through that. Before that, I had not really believed in RTF because I was a firm believer. I knew I'm a new creation in Christ Jesus. The blood of Jesus has cleansed me and everything is under the blood, and I couldn't really see why I needed to go through counseling to get at anything else. But I know I didn't have the victory. I know I had done everything I knew to do and couldn't get the victory. So there had to be something else, and I had to find out the reason for the spirit of fear to be able to torment me like he did. And so I did go. The Lord arranged it so that I went through RTF, through, I think it's called the Focus RTF, where we focused entirely on the spirit of fear and the source of it. And I learned about generational curses. And I had not really understood the generational curses and how they worked. And I'd always thought, well, I don't know anything about my ancestors, so how could I even get into that? But I found out through RTF about the four doors of generational curses and what to do about them, and we did it. I repented for my ancestors and I repented for myself, and we closed the door to the generational curses and sealed it shut with the blood of Jesus. And so where the enemy, what I had not realized is where the enemy had a legal right before to badger me and to torment me, these doors were now closed. And the relief that came was instantaneously. It was absolutely amazing. The clamminess left, all the torment left. I'm enjoying life. I have regained my strengths. I can't put into words what that has done for me. When the enemy tries to be up to his old tricks, all I have to say is, forget it. These doors are closed with the blood of Jesus sealed, and you have no more any legal right to me. And I'm free. And I just give God all the glory. I can't put into words what it means to me and how grateful and thankful I am to God. And nobody can really understand the freedom that I have gained and the enormous, what an enormous event that was and is to me. I'm Katrine Hoffman. I was enslaved to fear, and now I am unquestionably free.